For our next team of challengers, please.
What is your name, please?
My name is Ted Geisel.
What is your name, please?
My name is Ted Geisel.
What is your name, please?
My name is Ted Geisel.
All right, panel, once again, will you take a look at the copy of the affidavit in front of you now? I, Ted Geisel, am perhaps better known to the juvenile reading public as Dr. Seuss. I am the creator and illustrator of one of the most famous advertising campaigns of all time, Quick Henry the Flit. More recently, I created Gerald McBoing-Boing, who became the hero of the 1950 Academy Award-winning cartoon. I am known primarily, however, as the author and illustrator of 15 children's books, which feature weird and wonderful animals. My current bestseller, The Cat in the Hat, has sold so far almost 250,000 copies. Signed, Ted Geisel. And now, panel, we have three gentlemen, each one claiming to be Ted Geisel or Dr. Seuss. So we'll start this cross-examination with Hi Gardner. Hi.
Well, I'm glad to meet three doctors who specialize in a miracle drug called laughter. I think it's the most important drug we have. Number one, I've got a friend named Don Harold. What does he do?
Don Harold? I don't know him.
Do you know him, number two?
Don Harold is a cartoonist, advertising man.
Uh-huh. Number three, do you know him?
I know Don Harold is a cartoonist. He used to do cartoons for the New Yorker. Now he does advertising.
Number two, what two comic strip artists had a terrific personal feud going until one of them died?
I don't reckon. Comic strips are not exactly my field. I'm more or less in books, and I don't remember this.
Uh-huh. Number three, would you know?
No, I wouldn't know.
Number one?
No.
Number two, what cartoonist won a Pulitzer Prize?
Roland Kirby.
Polly?
Number one, name the woman who wrote the Academy Award-winning Gerald McBoing-Boing cartoon.
Hammer. Barbara Hammer.
Number two, it says that your writing name is Dr. Seuss. Why did you pick that particular name? Any particular
reason?
It's
a complete phony. That's my middle name, and I put the doctor in front of it.
Oh, Seuss is your middle name. I see. Number three, do you write, you illustrate and write, I know, do you write in verse or just straight story form?
Practically always in verse.
Mm-hmm. Number one, your cartoons your illustrations are famous for very wild animals. Which is your favorite of all the animals you've ever done?
Oh, Yertle the Turtle.
Yertle the Turtle?
Number two, who publishes your books?
A Random House.
Number two, how much are you paid for each book?
You're not paid. You take a chance and get royalties.
What is your royalty on each book?
Differs in each book. You go from 10 to 12.5 to 15%.
Number three, how many books go out in one printing?
About 100,000.
100,000? Number two, how long before your book will go into public domain?
The two terms of 14 years.
Two terms of 14. Number three, how much is an advertising agency paid?
I don't know.
Number two?
How much is an advertising agency paid for what?
Hmm? How much are they paid? What is the basis for their pay?
For artists?
No.
Sorry.
We'll have to move along. Joan Bennett.
I didn't understand.
Number one, when you did the Flit campaign, who is your advertising agency?
McCann Erickson.
Number two, who is the president of Random House?
Bennett Sir.
Number three, how many pages are there in The Cat and the Hat?
22.
It says here you draw weird animals. Describe a weird animal, number three.
A weird animal may have more than the usual number of legs, or it may have the head of a bird and the body of a mammal.
Number one, name another one besides Yertle the Turtle.
Flannel Mouth Yip.
Good a time as any to stop with the flannel mouth, I think, and it's time to vote once more. So again, without consultation, panel, will you please mark your ballots? And select number one, number two, or number three. All set early tonight, huh, Polly? For whom did you vote?
It's one of those things where I had a hunch from the beginning, and I must say that after the questioning, I leaned toward number two, but my hunch was number one. There's something about his smile that's very similar to a cat drawing that he did.
Cat with the body of a bird, perhaps.
Yeah.
Don Amici, your vote, please.
I voted for number three, in my opinion, and I felt that he gave more correct answers to the few technical questions that were asked.
Okay, Joan, your vote?
I voted for number one.
Saw the same cat, did you? All right, Hi, Gardner, your selection.
Well, I voted for number two because he doesn't look like a cartoon in the first place. In the second place, he knew Don Harrell, and Don Harrell did do illustrations primarily for advertising, and I sort of think it's number two.
Okay, there we have it now. As we've made our minds up, we'll find out whether we're right or wrong right now as we discover which one of these gentlemen is the real Dr. Seuss. So will the real Ted Geisel please stand up. Thank you, sir, very much. Number one, would you tell us who you really are and what you do?
I'm Burton Brown. I'm the president of the Gaslight Club. That's a gentleman's club with branches in New York and Chicago and presently in Washington.
Number three, would you tell us who you are?
My name is Tom Jukes. I am a research chemist for American Cyanamid Company.
Well, there you have it. Yes, you have a quick question, Hi?
Yes, I'd like to ask number one. You run the Gaslight Club. Do you see any of the animals he draws?
Don't answer that question. In checking up quickly, we see that there were three incorrect votes at $250 each, again for a total of $750 from Geritol, gentlemen. Profitable evening and a profitable one for us having met you. Good night and good luck. We'll need a new team of challenges.